Hi everyone, good morning, welcome back to my channel. It is around 10 o'clock in the morning on July 4th. Happy 4th of July. We're hoping that everybody gets to celebrate this day, but in a very, very complete and safe manner. We know it is not the same as past years, but you know, really it's just about getting those creative wills going and learning how to honor this day and any occasion and celebrate it, but at the same time, keeping our life and our health and our safety number one priority. And so in this video, I'm gonna share with you how we're celebrating the 4th of July during this pandemic. I mean, we've just had a second spike. It has gotten worse, and so we need to go back. You know, if we haven't been strictly abiding by CDC guidelines, we need to step it back. And my family has, and I'm so glad that we did, because we just took the coronavirus test and we all came out negative. Thank you, God. I feel so blessed and so grateful. But we have been abiding strictly by CDC guidelines. The moment we step out that door, we wear our mask. We've been doing shelter in place, only going out if it's very, very important emergency, like groceries, stuff like that. And, you know, keeping 6 feet social distancing. The good thing is my family, none of my family live here. They all either live 3 hours away in the Bay Area or 8 hours away in LA. The only one that lives separate from the house that still is allowed to come is my daughter. She lives like 2 miles away from here, but she was off, and so she was only at home or here. But nevertheless, we still did temperature checks, leaving shoes outside, keeping sanitation above and beyond, and just, you know, just keeping each other safe. And now she did go back to work a couple of weeks ago. She's only going like 3 days a week. But, you know, now she even goes even more above and beyond to be as safe as possible. So she'll go home and take off those clothes and take a shower before she touches her baby or any of the family, or if she comes over here. I'm still doing temperature checks and all that good stuff. So I'm glad we were diligent, you know, and abiding by all CDC guidelines. And so it's kept our family safe. But the reason why we did the whole coronavirus test, we were not sick. We had no signs. And I knew that we were really doing the best we could. But we had a little spike in our town. We were like at nothing in the first couple of months. And then we had 12 cases, no deaths. And then after graduation, it spiked. I think it might be even in the 80s. Last I checked, it was like 65. And we just found out that we had one death in a county right next to us. But yeah, after the graduation ceremonies, it spiked up. People going back to church or holding graduation ceremonies. My daughter graduated from college. We had a ceremony here, but it was our little house unit. We built a podium for her. She was in her cap and gown. We did the photos. She walked up to the yard with the graduation original song, and we had a nice dinner and a little celebration here in the backyard, and then we kind of floated into the house, but there was no family or friends or neighbors or anybody that was allowed to come. So we were able to celebrate and honor her and show her our love and how proud we were with her, but we kept it still by CDC guidelines, and we kept it very safe, and I'm very proud of that. But a lot of people didn't do that. They still had family and friends coming over, nobody wearing a mask, nobody keep social distancing, and it put our town in a spike. So the public health department had urged everyone, whether you were sick or not, signs or not, to come and get tested, that they had plenty of tests available. And I always didn't do the test. For one, you know, I was doing what I was supposed to do, but that doesn't mean nothing. Still, you know, that one time that you have to go to get groceries, which is something that's an emergency that's very important, and that's the only time we would leave the house, it could be just that one time that somebody just was next to you for a few seconds. So yeah, I forgot where I was because I had to stop the recording for a minute. But yeah, so when our public health department urged, whether you were sick or not, signs or not, come be tested, we thought, okay, let's just be tested and see where we are and move forward from there. So my daughter went first, and she had gone back to work, and she came out negative, and she had told me about it and signed us up, you know, because you have to go register online, and you have to get an ID. What is on my face here? Oh my God. And then I went like a few days later, and then you get your test normally in 48 to 72 hours, but I tell you, my other kids and my husband, it took like a week to get their test. And I think because more people started doing it, that they were trying to catch up with the results. I don't know what is on my face here. But yeah, so, and then I came out negative, thank God. And then I had my son and my daughter do it, the ones that live here. And then a week later, we found out that they were negative. And then my husband was the last one. And we were more concerned about him because he is still working. So he is more exposed than any of us. And his took a week and it was like torture. But we just got it yesterday in the morning and it was negative. So we are all clear. But we still have to be vigilant. We still have to continue to doing the right things that we've been doing. And even then some. And so today is a day that, oh my God, everybody is on edge. Everybody is scared. And as we should be, this is no joke. This is really, really no joke. And this is life and death situation. And you know, this is something that we definitely don't wish on ourselves, less much our families or anybody, you know, human being that we, you know, that we care about. Even if we don't know you, it's about being compassionate and, you know, just not disregarding it. So, but yeah, so I wanted to show you how we celebrate our, how we're going to celebrate our 4th of July this year during a pandemic. It's just going to be our family unit and my daughter and her husband and the baby. And that's it. Like I said, my general family either lives 3 hours away in the Bay Area or 8 hours away in LA. So that's good that we don't even have to worry about that. But even if they live here, my family would not be able to come to my home. We would not be able to gather. So whether they're here or not, we would make sure that we keep our distance and just stay in touch virally through text messaging, phone calling, you know, social media, you name it. We would find a way to really communicate. And we do that, you know, even because we live far away from each other, that's the way we keep in touch because we can't go often to see each other. And especially now it's a no. So, but it's nice to know that we don't even have to worry, you know, about that, but being sad because all my sister lives down the street and man, I'm not gonna be able to see her, you know. This is something that we normally do because we live so far away from each other, so we're used to it. But yeah, so I'm going to show you how we're going to celebrate our 4th of July during this pandemic. Like I said, it's going to be our family unit. And the only outside is my daughter, her husband, and the baby. But of course, we've been, you know, protecting each other and stuff. And so I can't wait. My daughter comes once a week. Now with her going back, I watch the baby twice a week, for her. But, this week the last time she came, which is the last time she worked and she needed me to watch baby, was Sunday. So I'm really excited because I love my grandbaby. She is just so beautiful and she's brought us so much joy and happiness. And the more I see her, the merrier, but you know, so we're usually watching her Sunday and Mondays, but I think my daughter's schedule changed, so it might be a different day. But we at least get to see her once to twice a week. So that's good. So we're not every day together. But we do get that one or, you know, two time opportunity to see each other. And so that means a lot to me and to the whole family. But yeah, I'm going to share with you all the decorations that we got for the 4th of July, and then I'm going to share with you how, you know, our outfits. We didn't really get any new outfits like we did for the Puerto Rican Festival theme / Father's Day celebration that we just did a couple of weeks ago. So we decided, you know, we did try to find some things, you know, to do something new, like we always tried to do, but there was just nothing. We just couldn't find anything as far as clothes. So I thought, okay, we just bought some clothes for Puerto Rican Festival theme, which is the same colors as the 4th of July colors, which is red, white, and blue. That's the color of our flags, of our Puerto Rican flag. So it's good that if we don't happen to get something new that we can mix and match because it's the same three colors. So I'm going to use the same pants, I believe, that I used for the Puerto Rican Festival theme / Father's Day that we did a couple of weeks ago. My blouse is going to be different. I'm going to have a red tank top or white, I don't know which one I choose, but the blouse will be completely different for the Puerto Rican Festival that we had here at home. Father's Day celebration, I wore a red tank top underneath with a blue top. This one's gonna be probably a red or white tank top underneath with a red top. And that red top, I used it last year for the 4th. Well, actually I didn't. I have that one that I wore last year that I was thinking of wearing, but then I found another one that my daughter had given me because she ended up, which she wore last year, but she ended up not really liking it. So she said, Mom, do you want this? So I'm gonna have something different on, but it ain't new. But it'll be different, which is nice. So I'll have something different, and then I'll wear the same pants that I wore. Their leggings are really soft and comfy. They're red, white, and blue. It's like a flower kind of pattern. If you haven't seen my Puerto Rican Festival theme / Father's Day video, go back and check it out. It turned out so amazing. And you'll be able to see those pants in there. So I'm wearing those. So I'm doing a mix and match of new and old and stuff like that. So I'll show you the outfit. I'm debating on my shoes. I haven't chose my shoes yet. I don't really want to wear the same shoes I wore 2 weeks ago, which are so pretty and comfortable, but I do want to change it up in the shoes. My hair accessory would be different. I had like this headband with like these cat ears, and it was red, white, and blue flowers. I don't want to wear that, so I'm probably going to wear my hair up with some red, white, and blue clips is what I'm looking to do now. My earrings were some round hoops that had red, white, and silver for the flag colors, which silver represents the white part. They were really cute, but I want to wear some different pair of earrings. So it's some earrings that I had that I wore last year for the 4th of July. It's red, white, red, silver, and blue as well. And then, so for makeup, we're gonna do a red, white, and blue look. And then for my bracelet, if I wear one, I'll probably wear the same red bracelet that I wore 2 weeks ago for the Puerto Rican Festival theme that we did here. And then my watch for 2 weeks ago for the Puerto Rican thing, I don't remember. I think this was blue. This bumper thing was blue. And I believe the band was both sides red. So this time I decided to do a little bit different. So instead of the blue, which I didn't really like that blue either. It was good for the Puerto Rican Festival, but for us, I kind of wanted a darker blue. So, and I don't have a darker blue, so white was perfect. So I changed my bumper. Normally I have black. I have all different colors, but most of the time it's a black bumper that I use. So I changed it to this white bumper. You can see, you can change it. So I bought a set of all different colors and I switch it up. I match whatever I'm wearing that day, I'll match it up with that. But most of the time I wear black. The black bumper, it tends to just happen to go with everything. But for today, I changed it to the white bumper, as you can see. And then instead of the bands being both sides red or both sides blue or both sides white, I decided to do one side navy blue and one side red. And these, you just see if I could get it out. Oh, my hand is hurting. You just take it out like that. You press a button that's in the back of the watch. There's a button under here. You press that and you just slide this in. Like that. There it is. So yeah, so I'm able to change my bands according to what I'm wearing that day. And so today I wanted to wear the red, white, and blue. And this is perfect because for the Puerto Rican thing, like I said, I had both sides red and I had this blue. So that means I didn't have any white and I didn't think about that. But that's okay because the red, white, and blue was incorporated in my look from head to toe. But today the watch is completely with all three colors, red, white, and blue. So I really like that. So that's going to be my watch. I got these masks for the 4th of July today. I got them at Walmart. They were $7.50. They had a display by the jewelry department and we just were almost done going to the register and I'm like, oh my God, what is that? And so they had three different ones. They had one that was red and said USA, but the trimming was black. And I'm like, what does black have to do with the flag colors? It just didn't look like the right thing. And then they had a pink one that said freedom with the flag in all white, kind of like this. And I thought, okay, that's not a color for the 4th of July either, but maybe I could wear it for other days. But I thought, no, if I'm gonna get me a pink mask, I'm gonna order something that has probably a different wording or different design on it. So this was the third one they had. They only had three choices, and I thought this one was perfect because it's all red, and then the lettering is in white, and you can see the American flag right there, and it says keep calm and stay 6 feet away. And I thought that is the perfect message, the perfect colors. The sizing of the mask is good. We fit it one on our face, one of the ones that I bought, Well, it's my daughter's. She took hers. And I had mine's open too, but I bought some new ones. Yeah. So I took one out once I bought it and got it home. I didn't take it out there and then put it back and let other people use it. That is crazy to me. I'm sure some people would try that. That is insane. But yeah, I bought them for all of us, including my daughter. I came home and I fitted it on my face, and it just so comfortable and just fits the nose and the mouth area and your ears so comfortably and so perfect that I got it. So good. So if you have a Walmart and you want to go get a last minute thing and you don't have a mask, like I said, we're not having any extended family or friends or neighbors or anything over, so we really don't have to wear masks. It's our same family little unit, but we did want to wear masks to honor and encourage people by us wearing our masks for a little bit, you know, when we take our photo or do our videos, and people will watch it, people will see, okay, we are keeping wearing mask in mind at all times, even if it's going to be our family unit. We want it just to have that photo and that video to encourage other people that even on the 4th of July, that, you know, if you are going to go ahead and have somebody extended, at least put on a mask. And what a way than to get a 4th of July mask and celebrate and honor it. And like I said, we don't have those extended family or friends or neighbors or anything like that. But we did want to wear it for a little while just to keep in mind that anytime you walk out the door, that you should wear your mask. And, you know, everybody says it's so uncomfortable. It's uncomfortable if you don't get the right sizing. It's uncomfortable. You just have to make it comfortable. Get the right sizing. That will make a big difference. The material makes a big difference as well. My camera went low. Getting the right material is also another good way to help it be more breathable, more comfortable. And also, did I say fitting? The fitting and the material, of course. And just, you know, just make it stylish. Make it something positive and something that, okay, it's not a boring mask. It's not like a healthcare mask, because those, the N95s and all that stuff should be left for the healthcare workers. I'm a healthcare worker, but I take care of my son right now. So those, the hospital ones could be very boring and just, could it even be sad? but, you know, hey, any mask is better than none. That's what you have. By all means, please wear it. But if you have the choice, like my daughter sews, she makes us all kinds of different masks, different patterns, different colors. So we have our little collection going on. Some of them we order from Amazon, and this one, by all means, please wear it. But if you have the choice, like my daughter sews, she makes us all kinds of different masks, different patterns, different colors. So we have our little collection going on. Some of them we order from Amazon, and this one is the first one that I found at Walmart that I thought was made for the 4th of July, and I thought it was just so perfect. So you can make it stylish. You know, you can make it something very positive, you know, while we're going through this difficult and scary time. So yeah, so those are the masks we're gonna wear. Like I said, I got one for each family member, and you'll be able to see our photo with us wearing them and stuff. So yeah, so if you're needing to go out and you feel that, you know, you just want to, you know, honor, and it's like a honor to even the healthcare workers, thanking them for their sacrifice by wearing the mask. So if you want to, you don't have a mask and you feel that you're going to need one because you're going to have some extended family or for whatever reason, and you want to go get something at the last minute, I don't know if they still have them, because when I went back, I bought the first two because I wanted to get feedback from my family if it was comfortable for them, if they were going to wear that or just wanted to wear a plain red one or whatever. So I bought the first two, and then I went back and I needed four more, and that's exactly what was left, was four more. So I was really lucky. So if you want to go to Walmart some last minute things to get today before you start your celebration, I would encourage you, if your store has them or still has them, because I'm sure they're like flying off. If they're still there, pick some up. And you could wear it not only for the 4th of July, you could wear these for other days and other occasions. It just doesn't have to be the 4th of July. So that's my watch and our mask, and I'm going to show you our outfit and our decorations. So this is the outfit that I'm planning to wear. These leggings, they're capri style. They're very soft and comfortable. I got these at Walmart. So again, if you want to get a last minute outfit idea, you can find these at Walmart if they're still available. They're a flower pattern. I wore these 2 weeks ago for our Puerto Rican Festival / Father's Day theme, because it has the same three colors of our flag, which is just like the American flag, red, white, and blue. I think I've said that like millions of times, but I just want to keep saying it for the people that are watching this for the first time. So I decided to wear them again. They're really soft and comfortable. Like I said, they have the same three colors. I did go to Walmart and other places just to try to find a whole new, different outfit, but there was just nothing available. So I thought, okay, it's not going to be new, but I'm going to do some mix matching. I'm going to do something that I got recent, something that I had last year, just like a mix and match vibe, as long as it's in the red, white, and blue colors. So I'm going to wear those, which I love because, like I said, they're very comfortable and they're very cute. This top my daughter actually wore last year, but she gave it to me. She didn't like it on her, so she gave it to me. I have something very similar, and the one that I wore, I didn't really like it on me either. So I'm glad that she gave me this so I can have a different look, a different choice, and I really like it. It's like a tank top effect. I'll show you the other side in a minute. These pants perfect for the Puerto Rican Festival / Father's Day theme. I wore a blue shirt on top of a red tank top, so that's different from what we wore 2 weeks ago. So we're mixing matching something that we wore last year with something that's recent. So, and I'm still debating on the shoes because I don't really want to wear the same shoes I wore a couple of weeks ago, even though they're pretty and they're comfortable. They're red. I want to do something a little bit different. So I'm going to see what I come up with. So for hair accessories and jewelry and our traditional shade wearing, this is what I'm thinking of wearing. I'm thinking of wearing these earrings, which are like a spiral style. Earring is so pretty. It has a silver, red, and blue, which you guys know the silver represents the white color of the flag, if you will. But they're really dainty and comfortable and just so cute. This is how they look together. I could hold them together. So it's really pretty like that. So, and I think I wore these, I'm not for sure if I wore them last year or the previous year, but what I'll do is I'll add some clips of previous looks for either the Puerto Rican celebration or the 4th of July, and just kind of show you how they looked when I wore them. This year I'm going to wear these hair clips. I think I'm going to put my hair up, which is fine because it's really hot today, and 2 weeks ago I wore my hair down, and normally I do wear my hair down. I've had these for like 3 or 4 years, and so I don't know exactly what year I wore them and if it was for the Puerto Rican or for the 4th of July, but I have two red and two blue. So I'm going to put my hair up and incorporate those in my look. For shades, I'm wearing these. I have a few shades between the Puerto Rican celebration and the 4th of July celebration. I have like maybe 4 pair that I wore in the last few years. For 2 weeks ago for the Puerto Rican thing, I had the same heart style, just the hearts weren't as thick. It had a thin trim, and then one side was blue, one side was red. I'll show you a photo of that look. So these I pulled out of my collection. I don't know if I wore them last year or the previous year, but I thought these would be really cool for today for my shades. So that's what I'm thinking. If anything changes, I will definitely let you know, because I'm still in the working on it, thinking about it process. So for shoes, these are my choices. There is one more choice, but it's high up and I can't get it right now. It's a blue pair of sandals that we wore for, I think it was
not last year because we weren't able to go because I was really ill for the Puerto Rican festival, but the prior year. But they're not, they're cute, but they're comfortable for a little bit. After a while, you have to take them off, but they strap up your ankle. I might show you a picture of those when I could get it down. These we just wore 2 weeks ago for the Puerto Rican festival theme / Father's Day celebration. Very cute, very comfortable, but I just wanted to do something a little bit different. That's why I'm mix matching. Since I couldn't find a complete brand new outfit, I thought the fun way to do it, to feel like it's something different, but a little bit of something that we've worn before, is to mix and match. So I don't really want to wear these shoes because I just wore 2 weeks ago, and you can see that in our video. If you haven't seen our Puerto Rican festival theme / Father's Day celebration, please go back and see that video. It came out amazing. I also have these, which are old. I think I wore these 2 years ago, and you can see they're peeling. These are like Nautica flip-flops, so they're good quality flip-flops. But I don't know if with the sweat of my feet, which my feet don't really sweat, but with time, it has peeled, so I can feel the peeling. See how it comes out? Oh, it's there on my hand somewhere. But they're really comfortable, and you won't see it because my feet will be on top of it, other than I might feel a little bit of the peeling. But I'm going to wipe them down. I really take care of my shoes. I have them put away in boxes and stuff. So this was in the boxes of my flip-flops. Then I just got these. I worn them a couple of times, you know, to, you know, go out to whatever important errand that I have to, if I'm wearing the blue color. So I'm thinking I'm really going to wear these today to incorporate my blue. They're very good quality. They're Tech Gear. They have like the memory foam. The support you get in this shoe is amazing, which I need. So this might be the pick of the day because, like I said, the quality, the comfort, and the cuteness of it, I got all three in one shoe. These are comfortable too. It's not as comfortable as these because it has a platform. So after a while, you want to take them off, even though I lasted all day with them. So no biggie. These are comfortable as well, other than the peeling, but I can get past that. But I think this is going to definitely be the choice because it has the blue to go with the outfit. So let's see. Let's put them over here by the outfit. Yeah, I think that's going to be the pick. That will be perfect. But like I said, anything can change. I'll let you know what the complete final look will be when I take a shower and get dressed. I'll show you the final look. So that's what I'm going to choose for that. So for decorations, this is what we got. We were really lucky. We found every single thing at Dollar Tree, which saves you money, and they have the cutest stuff, so I'm very happy. So let's start right here with our garland. We got two of the tinsel garland. They're like 9 feet each. Yep. Red, silver, and blue. So we got two. We usually put these on the podium that we had outside that we originally built for my daughter's college graduation ceremony that we had on the back. So for the Puerto Rican festival theme / Father's Day, we put one on the podium, and I think we put one on the table, but we can use it anywhere where there needs to be a decoration. So we bought two. And then we have these three-pack patriotic mini flags, which is nice. We have three-cylinder vases out there, which are actually used in my church wedding, and they already had the red sand, which my colors were red and gray. And so right now they have red, white, and blue flowers and stars, which we're going to keep those, but we're going to incorporate these flags in them. So there's three, and that's perfect because we have one large picnic table. So these three flags are perfect, just like the same amount of what we had in decorations for the Puerto Rican Father's Day theme. So this amount is perfect, and you got three in one package. I mean, what a way to save money and to get something really nice. We have these table holders, red, white, and blue, and it has red, white, and blue stars. So like I said, we just have one picnic table. It's really big, so one on each end will be perfect. Then we found these 18-package paper straws. We have the same straws for our Puerto Rican Father's Day theme, but those we got at Walmart. We had red and white and blue and white for our drinks because we're going to be making red and blue slush drinks with Sagram's flavoring. They're made with Kool-Aid and with Jolly Ranchers. If you haven't seen the Puerto Rican festival theme / Father's Day celebration video, please go back and see it. It came out amazing, and you can see our decorations and everything we incorporated, how we made the drinks with the Jolly Ranchers and the Kool-Aid, and we had the blender out there, which we're going to take again. And we had, like I said, straws, these paper straws, but they were either red and white, and blue and white. So we had like one package each. These we found all three colors, red, white, and blue. Perfect for the flag colors. And they come 18, which is more than enough. So we'll have fun with those in our slushy drinks. We found these paper plates with the American flag on it. And these come with, they're 12. So that's more than enough because it's six of us, including my son-in-law. So that's more than enough. So we only got one package. We also found these napkins. One package matches the plates with the American flag. It comes with 18 of them. So that's more than enough as well. But then we saw these and thought these were cute. So you can never have enough napkins. So we got this extra package with red, white, and blue stars. Also comes 18. Then we found these cute bottles. And I thought these would be perfect for our slush drinks. For the Puerto Rican theme Father's Day celebration, we had clear plastic cups because we wanted the color of the drink, which is we did red and blue that day, to show through it. And then we added the Puerto Rican flag sticker. So with this, we didn't even have to do all of that. We found the drink, the, what do you call these? Smoothie, specialty drink cups. There's a specific name when it comes with the straw, and I can't think of it. But I'll think of it. So we thought these were perfect. Had the red, white, and blue colors with the stars. It was made for today's holiday. So we got six of them. Like I said, it's six of us, including my son-in-law. If for some reason my daughter's boyfriend, I think he's working today, but he's going to stop by. Well, he's not actually working today. They have him on call for today. So he's just going to come and enjoy the day with us. So I guess I should have got seven. But I don't think my husband is really going to drink out of this because he likes his beer. So he'll taste the slushy drinks to be a part of it. But he's really not into the slushy drinks. So maybe he'll sacrifice his for my daughter's boyfriend. Or we'll see how it works out. We'll come up with something creative. And I kind of felt like, should I get one extra just in case? But yeah. So we thought these were so perfect. So I can't wait to put our slushy drinks in those. We don't have to just wear plain clear cup or add any stickers or anything. They come already for the 4th of July. Then we got our table covering, which is American flag as well. We only needed one. Like I said, we only had that one big picnic table. So yeah. So for dessert, we bought one package of these because we really don't eat a lot of sweets, but we wanted to have a little memory, a little treat for the 4th of July. So we found these 4th of July cookies. We only got like one package because that's pretty much all we need. There's like 10 in the package. They're the frosted sugar cookies. So everybody will be able to at least have one cookie. And, you know, last time we bought two and they were here for days and we were slowly trying to finish them. So this is more than enough. I just wanted it to for us to have a 4th of July treat. So that's what we're gonna have. Mira las carnitas de mi viejo.
No son gratis, son de venta.
Mira, qué rico se ve. Wow.
This is a little more like
so tender.
I know, huh? Wow.
This is a little more long dry, but you can mix it with always the macaroni cheese or whatever, you know.
Before, and I found that hey. Love was more than just holding. Fell in love with
you. Hey, soon
you.
As mommy came in, you guys can take the meat. And
Mama, you like the music, Mama? Yeah? Dance, Isabella. She's like, okay.
Oh,
you're like, oh. I think she's listening to TikToks.
No, it's a video Girl sent me. Like the title of the movie It's like a pregame speech, and it's called Your Dad's
a
Loser.
Did you see this video I sent you?
I don't know what's in the
back. I like this cover.
Oh, thank you. They're hidden behind the flags. They're watching TikTok, though.
Oh, they're watching TikTok.
Mama, you want Uncle Nicky? He has his mask on.
With your mask, stay, keep calm, and stay 6 feet away.
Hi, Lois. Yes?
You love Uncle Nicky? Isabella. You took Uncle Lexi's glasses off, now you took him back.
Take a picture.
You gonna take mine off too? Oh no! He loves Uncle Lexi.
Happy 4th of July, Isabella!
It has American flag. Keep calm and stay 6 feet away. That's right.
It's scaring the dog.
Look at her. That's good.
What is that, Isabella?
The case of it. I'm working. It's heaving, nigga. He's heaving. That's a moza. Yeah. Look at it.